The biggest question arises when you go on stage, what to do with the hands? You can't cut it off, right? And if I just keep my hands aside like this and keep talking, I look like Thakur's sister jiske haath kaat diye gaye hain. And of course, we don't want to reflect that, right? So you need to use your hand effectively, powerfully to communicate the message. Hey there, I'm Nancy Shah. I'm a trainer, public speaker, anchor, voiceover artist, and founder of Speaker Circle. We started this initiative to help people improve their public speaking skills. We conduct our interventions online, and you can also be part of it. All you need to do is fill up a Google form. You'll find the link in the description. Well, in today's video, I'm going to talk about some good gestures that you can use in your talk. So let's get started. What are gestures? Well, basically, gesture is all about the movement of upper body. But we don't move like this. So mostly it consists of the movement of your hands. So can you plan your gestures? Well, the answer can be yes and no. You cannot plan each and every gesture that you have. At the same time, you can plan a few. The points on which you want to put stress, the points which you want to highlight, or you want to convey a specific message, you can plan your gestures for that. But right now when I'm talking to you and if I'm moving my hands like this, they were not planned. That comes naturally. So if you can get your gestures naturally, great. If not, then you can plan a few things also. So now let me show you a few good gestures that you can use in your speeches. The first one is the clenched hands. When you use your hands like this, it's easy for you to open up and put it back. The another gesture that you can use is finger stipple. Stippling your fingertips can give you comfort. At the same time, you can use it as per the convenience. Open it up and put it back. The next one is the open hands. When you open your hands and talk, you seem more confident as well as you're opening up yourself for the audience to connect with you. It's always advisable to show numbers while you are talking about numbers. For example, I want to tell you three things. One, two, three. When you are talking towards somebody and interacting with one particular person, you can always point towards them. Or you are just talking in general, you can point towards the audience. When you want to contradict in your viewpoint, you can use one side and the other side as an indicator of the contradiction. When you want to highlight the steps or the levels of any particular thing, you can show them by hand gestures. When you want to say that you are going to add something into the point that you're mentioning, you can use this. You can use your hands to show some specific objects like phone, pen, work, plane, rain, scooter, bag. You can also use specific gestures to define the size of the particular object that you're talking about. Like, it was too small, it was big, it was huge. Another thing, when you find yourself talking about something which is really close to your heart and you really want the audience to understand and connect with it, you can use this gesture. Rubbing palm is the gesture that you use to show enthusiasm, energy, and positivity. You might have observed Amitabh Bachchan using this while hosting KBC. When you place your finger or your hand on the chin, that seems that you're thinking or evaluating or analyzing something. The another gesture which is famously used is shoulder shrug. When we don't know something, we do something like this. Whenever you want to say somebody else is saying or highlight some point or use a term or reflect sarcasm, you can use air quotes while saying it. So these were the few hand gestures that we recommend you to use in your speeches and in your interactions. But this list is not complete. There are many more out there. So if you find something suitable and relevant, do share it with us in a comment box and we'll surely consider that. At the same time, note that you can create your own specific hand gestures as well. We are going to create more such videos and you will get further updates on public speaking tips on our YouTube channel. So do subscribe our YouTube channel to not to miss any updates from Speaker Circle.